Now we'll discuss about pulmonary stenosis. Instruction by the examiner: examine the CVS or palpate and auscultate the pericardium. Presentation of a case: usually the patient is an adult or elderly. Pulse is 70 beats per minute, normal in volume, rhythm and character. JVP is normal, may be raised with prominent A wave due to right atrial hypertrophy. On inspection, nothing significant. Apex beat palpable in left intercostal space, centimeter from midline, normal in collector. Left parasternal lift and epigastric pulsation due to right ventricular hypertrophy. Systolic thrill present in pulmonary area. On auscultation, first heart sound normal in all areas. Second heart sound, P2 is soft in pulmonary area, A2 is normal. Wide splitting of second heart sound may be present. There is harsh ejection systolic murmur in pulmonary area, which radiates to the supraesternal notch, which is louder on inspiration. Fourth heart sound may be present due to right atrial contraction. Lung fields are clear. So my diagnosis is pulmonary stenosis. What is your differential diagnosis? Aortic stenosis. Why not aortic stenosis? In aortic stenosis, findings are pulse is low volume, slow rising, blood pressure low, systolic, normal, diastolic and narrow pulse pressure. Apex beat heaving in nature, absent or soft A2. Reversed splitting of second heart sound, harsh ejection systolic murmur in aortic area which radiates to right side of neck. How common is pulmonary stenosis? 8-12% of all congenital heart disease in children. In adults, it is 15% of all congenital heart disease. Now, what are the causes of pulmonary stenosis? The causes are congenital, commonest cause, associated with carcinoid syndrome, associated with Noonan syndrome, associated with Fallot's tetralogy, rarely in chronic rheumatic heart disease. Pulmonary stenosis may occur if there is rubella in pregnancy. What are the clinical features or presentations of pulmonary stenosis? As follows. Usually asymptomatic. Symptoms such as fatigue, weakness and effort syncope may occur. Other features: cyanosis, features of right ventricular failure, engorged neck veins, enlarged and tender liver dependent edema. Arrhythmia, atrial fibrillation is commonest. Now, what are the signs of severe pulmonary stenosis? Signs of severe pulmonary stenosis: large A wave in JVP, P2 is absent, wide splitting of second heart sound, presence of fourth heart sound, murmur is prolonged, loud and harsh with late systolic peaking, left parasternal lift, ECG shows right ventricular hypertrophy and right atrial hypertrophy, chest X-ray shows post-stenotic dilatation of pulmonary artery. What are the types of pulmonary stenosis? Three types: valvular, subvalvular, usually in Fallot's tetralogy, supravalvular, usually in congenital rubella. What are the complications of pulmonary stenosis? The complications are right heart failure, pulmonary embolism, no systemic. Infective endocarditis is unusual in pulmonary stenosis. Prophylactic antibiotic is unnecessary. Now, how do you grade pulmonary stenosis? As follows. According to transvalvular gradient, mild is less than 50 mm mercury, moderate 50 to 79 mm mercury, severe more than 80 mm mercury. According to valve area, mild more than 10 cm square, moderate 0.5 to 1 cm square, severe less than 0.5 cm square. What investigations are done in pulmonary stenosis? Chest X-ray shows enlarged pulmonary conus with post-stenotic dilatation, oligemic lung fields in valvular stenosis, ECG, echo preferably color Doppler. How to treat pulmonary stenosis? As follows. In mild to moderate case, no specific treatment, compatible with normal life. Follow up with regular echocardiogram. In severe symptomatic case, if pressure gradient is more than 50 mm mercury, balloon valvuloplasty is the treatment of choice. Percutaneous or surgical valve replacement may be necessary in some cases. Pulmonary regurgitation. Instruction by the examiner: examine the CVS. or palpate and auscultate the precordium. Presentation of a case: pulse 70 beat per minute, normal in volume, rhythm and character, JVP normal, may be raised to prominent A wave due to right atrial hypertrophy. On inspection, nothing significant. Apex beat palpable in left intercostal space, centimeter from midline, normal in character. Palpable P2, left parasternal lift and epigastric pulsation due to RVH. On auscultation, first heart sound normal in all areas. Second heart sound P2 is soft in pulmonary area. A2 is normal. Early diastolic murmur in pulmonary area. Graham still murmur. More prominent on inspiration. Lung fields are clear. We should remember the following points. It is due to dilatation of the pulmonary valve ring. Occurs with pulmonary hypertension. Graham still murmur. Usually secondary to mitral stenosis. So look for the evidence of primary disease of heart, such as mitral stenosis. Usually causes no symptoms. Treatment is rarely necessary. What are the causes of pulmonary regurgitation? As follows. Secondary to mitral stenosis or pulmonary hypertension due to any cause. Primary pulmonary regurgitation may occur in infective endocarditis, chronic rheumatic heart disease, balloon bulboplasty for pulmonary stenosis, trauma due to Swan-Ganz catheterization, carcinoid syndrome, Marfan syndrome, congenital, repair of tetralogy of Fallot, drugs, pergolide, fenfluramine, syphilis. What investigations are done in pulmonary stenosis? Chest X-ray, ECG, echo, preferably color Doppler, cardiac catheterization. How to treat pulmonary regurgitation? Pulmonary regurgitation. Treatment is rarely necessary. Treatment of primary cause should be done.